We've been a leader in banking for more than 100 years. You'll find us here, at home, on your phone, and everywhere you go. Renaissance Bank. Understanding you. Member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
Sponsored by Renaissance Bank.
Good morning and welcome to Newsbreak for Thursday, October 26th. I'm your host, Chris Kiefer. We're going to take a look at the top news and sports stories from Northeast Mississippi. But first, let's start with your weather forecast. Today we're looking at sunny skies with a high of 77 and a low of 52 and a 0% chance of rain. Looking ahead at your three-day outlook, rain is moving in on Friday and will cool down the temperatures over the next 3 days. Friday has an 80% chance of rain with a high of 70 and a low of 38. Saturday, we're looking at partly cloudy skies with a high of 54 and a low of 34, 10% chance of rain. And on Sunday, high of 55 with a low of 35 and a 10% chance of rain. Let's take a look now at today's top headlines. It wasn't Black Friday, but Carolyn Floyd stood in line for 11 hours for the grand opening of Aldi on Wednesday morning. The Blue Springs resident said she arrived at 10 p.m. on Tuesday because she loves the store's prices and did not want to miss the festivities. She was among the first 100 customers who received gift cards as part of the grand opening festivities. There were more than 200 people there by the time the doors opened. The 20,000 square foot store sits at a high traffic spot at North Gloucester Street and Harmony Lane. Its open layout and wide open aisles were filled quickly by eager shoppers looking for deals and checking out the city's newest grocery store. Aldi's emphasis on self-service and lower costs means shoppers can bring in their own bags to fill while shopping. Bags can also be purchased at the store. The Tupelo store has about 10 employees, and it won't be the only one in Northeast Mississippi for long. A location in Corinth will open later this year or early in 2018. Mississippi Governor Phil Bryant is traditionally the last speaker at the Mississippi Economic Council's annual Hobnob event. This year, he kicked off the event on Wednesday by proclaiming the importance of workforce training. Most of the state elected officials speaking at the event agreed that such training is important to the future progress of the state. Several of the officials spoke of the more than 40,000 job openings that can be found on the Mississippi Works website. The issue with some of those jobs is finding people with the skills to perform them. Both House Speaker Philip Gunn and Lieutenant Governor Tate Reeves spoke of the importance of education. Other speakers included Attorney General Jim Hood, Treasurer Lynn Fitch, Agriculture and Commerce Commissioner Cindy Hyde-Smith, Insurance Commissioner Mike Cheney, and Secretary of State Delbert Hoseman. More than 1,200 people attended at the Mississippi Coliseum. Mississippi Development Authority Executive Director Glenn McCullough also spoke and said the state is gaining national attention. The former Tupelo mayor said Mississippi is a small state, but it can punch way above its weight. When the Lee County Jail recently started to refuse most nonviolent prisoners brought in by municipalities, it meant the Tupelo Police Department had to change the way it handles arrests. Instead of arresting people and hauling them to jail, Tupelo officers have begun carrying people directly to municipal court during the day. On nights and weekends, officers began using post-arrest releases. They tell nonviolent criminals when their court date is and then release them. Tupelo Police Chief Bart Aguirre said the department is trying to handle things a little smarter than it did previously. As a result, the city's jail bill dropped $20,000 in 1 month, according to City Attorney Ben Logan. Tupelo and other Lee County municipalities pay the county $25 a day to house prisoners at the jail. In late August, the Lee County Board of Supervisors decided not to expand the current 200-bed jail. Sheriff Jim Johnson then took dramatic steps to reduce overcrowding, including limiting the intake of nonviolent offenders. The jail routinely housed 240 or more prisoners throughout the summer. That number is only 147 on Tuesday afternoon. And in sports, both Alcorn Central and Tupelo will take the court in Starkville tonight for the MHSAA volleyball semifinals. Alcorn Central plays Class 1A Kingpin, Our Lady Academy from Bay St. Louis at 3 p.m. In a Class 1A semifinal, Tupelo meets Brandon at 7 p.m. All matches will be played at the Newell Grissom Building on the Mississippi State campus. That is also the site for Saturday's championship matches. Alcorn Central's core of eight seniors has been with the program since it began when they were eighth graders. Our Lady Academy has won five straight Class 1 titles. Meanwhile, Tupelo is familiar with the state semifinals, but has not won a state title since 2011. Tupelo features five seniors who were starters as freshmen. They have progressed deeper into the playoffs each year. That does it for Newsbreak on this Thursday. Don't forget that this show is just one of the many online offerings courtesy of the Daily Journal that gets you news off the page and on the go. Listen to the Memo podcast for a rundown of news and entertainment in Northeast Mississippi with hosts Emma Kent and Derek Russell. On Wednesday's episode, we were joined by Daily Journal reporter William Moore to talk about lessons the city of Tupelo learned from last week's boil water notice. Also, Dennis Sid talks about ways brick and mortar stores are trying to compete with online retailers. Christina Carrion discusses Hurricane Harvey relief efforts by Tupelo's 8 Days of Hope. And Lauren Wood talks about her photo essay on woodworking business in Saltillo. Listen to Apple Podcasts, Google Play, or at memo.djournal.com. And Ole Miss and Mississippi State fans, check out the Double Coverage podcast. Ole Miss beat reporter Parrish Alford and Mississippi State reporter Logan Lowry talk about the latest with the Rebels and Bulldogs. Look for a new episode this afternoon in Apple Podcasts, Google Play, or at doublecoverage.djournal.com. Each story discussed on Newsbreak can be found in your Daily Journal or online at djournal.com, where you can also find a new episode of Newsbreak each weekday at 7 a.m. Thanks for joining us. I'm Chris Kiefer. Have a great Thursday.